In the last class, I discussed a simple application of Coulomb's law, how to prove that electric field intensity at any internal point of an uniformly charged spherical shell is zero. It is identically zero at every point. Now, there is another important application of this type of Coulomb's law or relating the electric field intensity, that in case of a the physics of spherical charged soap bubble. Okay. In case of a soap bubble, you all know that there is a surface tension of the soap solution. When a spherical soap bubble is considered, that it is in equilibrium because of why? Because in the internal pressure, in case of the soap bubble, the internal pressure inside it is greater than the atmospheric pressure. You all know. So there is an excess pressure difference existing across its spherical surface, and the force due to this excess pressure difference is counterbalanced by the surface tensional force. I am again repeating, in case of a spherical soap bubble, the internal pressure is greater than the atmospheric pressure. So there is an excess pressure acting in the surface of the spherical soap bubble outside or excess the atmospheric. The internal pressure is greater than the atmospheric pressure, so there is an excess pressure, which is internal pressure minus external pressure. So the force generated due to this excess pressure acting over the spherical soap bubble is counterbalanced by the surface tensional force acting on it. Okay, this is for equilibrium condition. Now, when the soap bubble is electrified, we know that soap solution is a good conductor of electricity. Let the surface charge density, we are assuming that it is uniformly distributed over the surface of the spherical soap bubble, let it be sigma. So, when it is electrified or the soap bubble is electrified, there is an additional force which is sigma square by 2 epsilon naught. Sigma square by 2 epsilon naught acting in per unit area in the outward direction. So, a new equilibrium condition is to be established when it is electrified. Let us discuss these points. And I am again repeating you that you all know that I have already derived in case of a disc in application of Coulomb's law, you may have noted that video, that if you consider an uniformly charged disc very large compared to the distance at which the electric field is to be considered, the electric field intensity at all the points very close to it is a constant, and it is sigma by 2 epsilon naught. I prove it. So, if this is true, say this is electric field intensity at a point very close to it, it is sigma by 2 epsilon naught. Okay. Now, I am considering an area, say suppose delta S, and delta S of the spherical soap bubble. Now, charge contained in this, it will be sigma into delta S, in the delta S element, sigma into delta S. So, the force acting on this element, it will be sigma into delta S into E, that is sigma square by 2 epsilon naught into delta S. So, the delta S area, I am just doing this type of applications in very, very short way. There should be another elaborate way. But this is not our present topic at this moment. So, force acting in the area delta S of the spherical soap bubble, it will be sigma square by 2 epsilon naught into delta S. So, force acting in per unit area will be, what will be that? F, that is sigma square by 2 epsilon naught. In this way, I can conclude that if a charge body have containing a surface charge density of sigma, which is assumed to be uniform, then force acting in per unit area, it will be sigma square by 2 epsilon naught. Okay. Now, let us come to our main problem. Let it is a uniformly charged spherical soap bubble. Okay. Now, I am considering a small surface element of the spherical soap bubble. Let this angle, it is alpha. Okay. This angle is alpha. So, if the radius of the soap bubble is A, if the radius of the soap bubble is A, then clearly it is approximately A into alpha. It is approximately also A into alpha. So, I can say that this cone has a projected circle. This cone has a projected circle over the, has a projected circle over the surface of the spherical soap bubble, and the radius of that circle the radius of that circle, it will be A into alpha. Okay. So the base area of this cone, base area, area of the cone, and the semi, and you already know that the semi-vertical angle of the cone is alpha. Base area of this cone, it will be pi into A alpha squared. Pi into A alpha squared. And what will be the circumference of this circle? Circumference of this circle will be two pi A alpha. Because A alpha being the radius. Okay. Now, let the internal pressure, internal pressure means the pressure exerted by the internal gas contained in, by the spherical soap bubble, internal pressure is Pi. Pi. Then it is obviously it will be some constant K, A cube. K is a constant because its volume is 4/3 into pi a cube and pressure is inversely proportional to the volume. Okay, pressure is inversely proportional to the volume. So I have written it as K by a cube. Okay. Now, okay, just wait. By a cube, where K is a constant. Now, when it is electrified, the force acting in per unit area, you all know it is electric force. For electric force, force acting in per unit area, it is sigma square by 2 epsilon naught. So the force acting over this area element, what will be that? Force acting over that area element will be the force due to electric field. Force due to electric field, it will be, what is this area? I have already calculated pi into A alpha squared, pi into A alpha squared into force in per unit area, that is sigma square by 2 epsilon naught. So it is the electric field, force due to the electric field. Okay. Let us write it as F capital E. So now, the force due to the internal pressure, force due to the internal pressure, I have already noted that pressure is inversely proportional to the volume. Volume is proportional to A cube. So pressure equal to some constant by volume, that is constant K by A cube. I have written in the way. Now, the force over this element due to the internal pressure, let it be represented as the internal force. Okay, pressure into area, that is K by A cube, pi into square. Okay. Now, let the atmospheric pressure, acting on the spherical soap bubble, it is represented by capital P. Let capital P be the atmospheric pressure. Atmospheric pressure. Capital. So the force internal, so the it is also it's external force, but it is acting along the inward direction. So the inward force acting on the element of radius A alpha, on the circular element of radius A alpha, due to the atmospheric pressure. So it is atmospheric force FA. I am writing it, it will be P into pi A alpha squared. Okay, now another force will come due to the surface tension. Okay. Now, let us draw two tangents. Okay. Now, from the simple geometry, we all know that the angle between these two lines is alpha. So, the angle between their perpendiculars will be also alpha. So, perpendicular to this line is this. Perpendicular to this line is that. So it will be also alpha.
Similarly, then it will be alpha.
Let capital T is the surface tension of the soap solution. Capital T is the surface tension of the soap solution. I am not erasing this result because I shall have a help of this result. I have to take the help of these results. So I am not erasing at this moment. Let capital T is the surface tension of the soap solution. If I consider a small element dl of this surface element, then the force due to the surface tension will be T into dl, because surface tension is defined as the force acting in unit length. I am again repeating, if I consider a small line element dl over the surface element, then force due to the surface tension, it will be T into dl. And I have to consider as two surfaces, one is the internal, another is the external surface, so that force will be 2TdL. Now this 2TdL can be resolved into two components. Along this it will be 2TdL cos alpha, and along this it will be 2TdL sin alpha. Similarly, along this it will be 2TdL cos alpha, along this direction, that is radially inward direction, it will be 2TdL sin alpha. Now these cos components being equal and opposite, they will cancel each other. So the effective force acting along the inward, radially inward direction, it will be 4TdL cos alpha. Along this direction, it will be 4TdL cos alpha. Okay. Now, what is dl? Dl is our 2πa alpha. So the inward force due to surface tension, it will be 4TdL cos alpha. That is 4T, again dl is 2πa alpha cos alpha. Sorry, it will be sin alpha, not cos alpha. Sin alpha. Because cos components have already cancelled each other. Okay. Now for very small angle alpha, sin alpha is approximated as alpha. So this result can be written as force due to surface tension, 4T into 2πa alpha into alpha. That is 8πt a alpha squared. Okay. So finally, I have two inwardly directed forces, one due to the surface tension null effect acting over the small element whose radius is considered as a alpha, it is 8πt alpha squared, and another force acting in the inward direction, it is due to the external atmospheric pressure, and this force I have already calculated, it is P into pi a alpha squared. Now, also there are two internal forces, one due to the internal pressure. This force is calculated to be K by A cube pi alpha squared. And another is the internal force acting in the radially outward direction. These two forces act along the radially outward direction. And it is pi A alpha squared into sigma squared by 2 epsilon naught, arising due to the charge soap bubble, due to the electric field. Now for equilibrium, sum of the internal forces must be equal to sum of the external forces. So, I have, you all observe please, the board is small, so it may be quite, you can feel quite discomfort in this way. That is, Fi plus Fe must be equals to Fa plus Fs. Now I am substituting the results. Or K by A cube pi A alpha squared plus, what is the force due to the electric field? I have calculated pi A alpha squared into sigma squared by 2 epsilon naught. So it is equals to force due to the atmospheric pi A alpha squared plus force due to the surface tension. It is 8 pi t a alpha squared. Okay. Now, simplifying the result, I have Okay. Now, if I consider that in some in a special case, that the force due to the internal pressure is equal to the force due to the atmospheric pressure. If I take this result as for simplification, then these two terms will get cancelled. Okay, under this condition, I am again repeating you, if I consider the force due to the internal pressure is equal to the force due to the atmospheric pressure, that is the force due to the pressure exerted by the outside air as that of the bubble, then these two terms are equal. So I can cancel these two terms under this condition. Otherwise, these two terms will exist. So I have pi a square to sigma square by 2 epsilon naught, that is 8 pi t a. Okay. Or what will be sigma value of the sigma? That is sigma square, it will come as 8 pi t a into 2 epsilon naught by pi a squared, pi pi cancelled, 16 t epsilon naught by a. 16 t epsilon naught by a again. Or sigma, it is root 16 t epsilon naught by a. Okay, now I can write the result in some different way also. Under this condition, I am again repeating you that I have derived this condition when the force due to the internal pressure is equal to the force due to the outside atmospheric pressure. Now, if it is given that the spherical soap bubble is charged with the potential phi, that is an uniform potential exists over its surface phi, then phi equals to this phi charged by 4 pi epsilon naught into, what is charge? 4 pi a square into sigma charged by 4 pi epsilon naught into radius. Okay, so it will come as sigma by a epsilon naught, phi equal to sigma by a epsilon naught. So sigma equals to phi into a epsilon naught, and phi is the potential at the surface, therefore phi a epsilon naught, it is root 16 t epsilon naught by a, that is squaring both sides, or simplify is, that is 16 t epsilon naught by a into a squared epsilon naught squared, that will be sigma t by a cube epsilon naught. Okay, this is our result. Okay, up to this now.